part in the second week called the academic section of mathematics. Today's date is 12th April 2021. This week we run from 12 to 16 April 2021. And the topic before us this morning is time on the clock. Time on the clock. The instructions. You copy the note in your mathematics notebook. The exercise that follows this note should be done in your mathematics notebook. Then on Friday, 16th April 2021, you submit your note for evaluation. So let's go to the topic proper. Time on the clock. Time on the clock. We all know clock. Clocks are those can be circular, can be rectangle, can be triangle, can be any shape that tells us what time is. Okay? It is always placed on the wall in our various room. An example is this. Okay? Look at it very well, you see some numbers. Okay? You can see 12, you can see 3, you can see 6, you can see 9. So all these thick lines that you're looking at, they represent number. There are some clock that we have all number well written. Why some just have these four numbers, which are the cardinal point, right? Right. So this one, the first thick line after 12 represents 1, followed by 2, then 3, after 3 we have 4, after 4 we have 5, after 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, back to 12. So, first thing we need to notice is that this thin hand, this thin long hand, this is the second hand. You can see that it's only one moving that you can see. These two hands also move, but you may not be able to see them when they are moving. But this one, when it is moving, you always see it. So the one that you see moving is called the second hand. Okay? Second hand. Okay? Then the next one, which is longer than the other one, is called the minute hand. Okay? The minute hand. Why this short hand is called the hour hand? Our hand. So if you look at between 12 and this thick line, which is one, you see that you still have some tiny lines there. They represent the minute. So we have in between one number to the other, we have 5 minutes. Okay? So we come to the diagram. Now, this diagram is same as the clock you are looking at. So this represents the seconds hand, the one that is moving. The shorter hand is called the hour hand, while the longer hand is called the minute hand. Now, in between the first number, you can see this is 1, this is 1, and this is 2. This is 4, this is 5, this is 7, this is 8, this is 10, this is 11. So, you can see that between 1 and 2, you still have some tiny lines. They are 4 in number. So between 1 and 2, we have 5 minutes. So between this one and the next tiny hand is 1 minute, and we call it 1 small division. 1 small division makes 1 minute, okay? So in between 1 and 2, we have 5 minutes. That is, between 12 and 1, 5 minutes. Between 1 and 2, 5 minutes. 2 and 3, 5 minutes. We now add 5 in 12 places. It's going to give you 60 minutes. That is why we say, and this one, before this one can move, before the long hand, which is the minute hand, can move from this one to the first line, this first mark, which represents one small division, that is 1 minute. This second hand must have moved around from 12 like this to move this clockwise. Clockwise is from 12 through your right hand, like that, your left hand, and back to 12. Okay? That's how it moves. No clock move like this. Clock move like this. That represents clockwise movement. Okay? Clockwise is from 12 to 1, 2, like that, back to 12. Okay? So, because this minute hand can move from 1 to this small hand, this
second hand must have moved from 12 through 1, 3, 4 to 12 before this one will move. So, and that is how we arrive at 60 seconds equals to 1 minute. Okay? Now, if this one moved, it means that these seconds continue moving as it moves from 12 back to 12. This one will move by 1 minute. If it moves again without the next movement, that's how it will move, and complete the first large division, which is that is from 1 to 2 or from 2 to 3. We get it now. So, in between 1 and 2, we have 5 minutes. In between 2 and 3, we have another 5 minutes. That's how it will continue moving, and it completes back to from 1 to 12 to 1. And when it moves, if this long hand moves from 1, okay, from 12, round, and move to this place, we say 60 minutes. Because don't move 60 times. All this time, 5 there, grab it, and without 12. 5 times 12 equals 60. So that's how we have about 60 minutes. Equals 1 hour. Okay? That is, if this long hand now continue moving, once it continues moving, and move from 12 to back to 12, that means 1 hour is passed. Do you get it now? That's how we can arrive at 16 minutes, make 1 hour. Then, this hour can now, once this one move, and complete, that's when you now see this one from, you can see it, that will be obvious that you see it moving from 9 to 10. Though it will be moving small, but you may not see the movement, you may not notice the movement. But when once this long hand move from 12 back to 12, you see it moving completely from 9 to 10. Then when it moves again, you see it moving again from 10 to 11. That's how it moves round the clock and on a daily basis. So when this hand moves round, so it's going to move round to complete a day, this hand must move twice. From 12 to 12, 12 to 12. Okay? So, then we can say 24 hours. Make 1 day. Because if this small hand moves from 12, first time to 12, that make an half day. If you move again, okay, from 12 to 12, then that it makes a day. So that's why we say 24 hours. Make 1 day. So having known all these movements, how seconds move, how minutes move, and how hour move, then we now come to our time. Here now, we are going to learn 2 things here. So the first one is telling the time in hours and minutes. In hours and minutes. Look at this diagram. This is the short hand, which is the hour hand. Okay? And this is the long hand. So, with this diagram now, who can tell me what time is with this diagram? You can say it in 3 ways. A, you can say, what is this? This one is, this short hand is in between what? 12 and 1. It means that it's not yet 1 because it's just moving towards 1. So, it's not yet 1. You can say 12 points. Okay? Then, when the long hand is still moving between 12 and 6,